लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ डिवीजन.
Properties of division. In this module, you will learn the properties of division. What happened, Neil? Are you all right?
Ma'am, I am thinking about the dream I had last night. I dreamt that some input numbers were going inside a machine. When the numbers multiplied or divided, their output numbers were coming out from the machine.
That's an interesting dream, Neil. Have you noticed something here when the output number 5 is divided by 5?
Yes, we get 1 as the answer.
Do you think this rule applies to other numbers? That is, when we divide a number by itself, we get 1 as an answer?
Yes, this rule applies to all the numbers. For example, if you divide 49 by 49, you get 1 as an answer. Or if you divide 136 by 136, you get 1 as an answer. This is one of the properties of division.
There are other properties of division as well, such as when you divide a number by 1, you get the same number as the answer. For example, 11 divided by 1 is equal to 11. 82 divided by 1 is equal to 82. Second, we cannot divide any number by 0 because it has no meaning. For example, 16 divided by 0. Let's see this using repeated subtraction. If we subtract 0 from 16, we get 16. And if we keep on subtracting with 0, the answer remains the same. Therefore, 16 divided by 0 has no meaning. Third, when you divide 0 by any number, you get 0. Let's see this property using equal sharing. Suppose that you have to distribute 0 eggs among 6 trays. How many eggs can you put in each tray? There will be 0 eggs in each tray. Therefore, 0 divided by 6 is equal to 0. Let's recap. Properties of division. When we divide a number by itself, we get 1 as an answer. When we divide a number by 1, we get the same number as the answer. We cannot divide any number by 0 because it has no meaning. When we divide 0 by any number, we get 0.
Let's understand the properties of division. First property, when a number is divided by 1, then the quotient is the number itself. जब हम किसी number को 1 से divide करते हैं, तो quotient हमेशा answer क्या आएगा? Number itself, वो ही number फिर से आएगा. For example, 15 divided by 1 is equal to 15. 24 divided by 1 is equal to 24. 564 divided by 1 is equal to 564. Now the second property, when a number is divided by itself, that means अगर हम किसी number को उसी number से divide करते हैं, the quotient is 1. Okay, जब हम किसी number को same उसी number से divide करते हैं, तो quotient means answer हमेशा 1 आएगा. For example, 28 divided by 28 is equal to 1. 75 divided by 75 is equal to 1. 142 divided by 142 is equal to 1. Now, the third property, if 0 is divided by a number, the quotient is 0. अगर हम 0 को किसी भी number से divide करेंगे, तो answer हमेशा 0 ही आएगा. For example, 0 divided by 6 is equal to 0. 0 divided 5 is equal to 0. 0 divided by 25 is equal to 0. Okay? Now, remember one thing, we cannot divide any number by 0. मतलब हम किसी भी नंबर को जीरो से कभी भी हम डिवाइड नहीं कर सकते. दैट मीन्स जीरो कभी भी डिवाइजर नहीं हो सकता. जीरो को किसी नंबर से डिवाइड कर सकते हैं, लेकिन हम किसी नंबर को जीरो से डिवाइड नहीं कर सकते. नाउ any number divided by 10 will give the last digit as remainder and the rest of the digits as the question. हम जब भी किसी नंबर को 10 से डिवाइड करेंगे, किसी भी नंबर को जब हम 10 से डिवाइड करेंगे तो लास्ट डिजिट जो वंस प्लेस पे डिजिट है दैट विल बी रिमाइंडर एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द डिजिट्स विल बी क्वेश्चंट. इफ वी डिवाइड 75 बाय 10 वी विल गेट 5 लास्ट डिजिट एट द वंस प्लेस, दिस विल बी रिमाइंडर एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द डिजिट मीन्स 7, 7 विल बी क्वेश्चंट. इफ वी डिवाइड 300 बाय 10 तो लास्ट डिजिट क्या है, 0, 0 विल बी रिमाइंडर एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द डिजिट्स क्या बचा है, 30, ओके 30 विल बी क्वेश्चंट. नाउ हियर 5704 डिवाइडेड बाय 10, 4 विल बी रिमाइंडर एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द डिजिट्स मीन्स 570 विल बी क्वेश्चंट. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज डिवीजन विदाउट रिमाइंडर. Now take one example. Now here we have to divide 486 by 2. Okay. Now 486 is dividend and 2 is divisor. Okay. We will divide. Now 486. Now we will say the table of 2. Okay. Now here we will take first digit. So 2 2s are 4. This should be less than 4 or equal to 4. So, 2 2s are 4 equal to 4. Now, we will subtract 4 minus 4, 0. Now, copy down the number 8. Now, again we will say the table of 2, 2 4s are 8, 8 minus 8, 0. Now, we will copy down the next number 6, 2 3s are 6. 2 4s are 8 is greater than 6. So, we will take third step. 2 3s are 6. Now, 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Here, the quotient is 243 and the remainder is 0. Last mein kya bacha hai? 0. So, the remainder will be 0. Let's see one more example. 3584 divided by 4. Here our dividend is 3584 and the divisor is 4. So we have to see the table of 4. Now if we take one digit, the first digit is 3 and 3 is smaller than 4. Okay, so we will take two digits because it is not possible to divide 3 by 4. So we will take two digits. Our dividend is 35. So say the table of 4. Hum kab tak bolenge equal to 35 or smaller to 30. Means smaller than 35. Isse greater nahi hona chahiye. Okay. So we will say the table of 4. 4 8s are 32. And 4 9s are 36. So 36 is greater than 35. So we will take the 8th step. 4 8s are 32. Now we will subtract 32 from 35. 5 minus 2, 3. And 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, student, remember one more thing. The remainder is always smaller than divisor. Hum jab bhi subtract karenge, to jo subtraction ke baad jo result aayega, wo divisor se hamesha smaller hoga. Yahan subtract karne ke baad kya aaya hai? 3. 3 is smaller than 4. Okay, now we will copy down the next digit, 8. So, our new dividend is 38. Now, 4 9s are 36. Now, subtract 36 from 38. 8 minus 6, 2. 3 minus 3, 0. So, our remainder abhi kya aaya hai? 2. Okay, aur ye bhi kisse smaller hai? 4 se, divisor se smaller hai. It should be smaller than divisor. Now our next number is 4. So we will copy down here. Our new dividend is 24. Now say the table of 4. 4 6 are 24. Okay. So we will subtract this. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. and 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Here our quotient is 896 and the remainder is 0. Now next is division with remainder. Let's see the example. Now in this question we have to divide 2875 by 8. Here our dividend is 2875 and divisor is 8. Now we will divide. Now 2 is smaller than 8. Okay, 2. 8 ke table mein 2 nahi aayega. So we have to take 2 digits together. Now we have to say the table of 28. Kab tak? Smaller than 28 or equal to 28. Now 8 threes are 24 because 8 fours are 32 and that is greater than 28. Okay, 32 28 se greater hai, isliye humko kya lena hai? Smaller than 28 or equal to 28. So 8 threes are 24. Now we will subtract 24 from 28. 8 minus 4 is equal to 4 and 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, 4 is smaller than 8. Now we will copy down the next digit, 7. Now our dividend is 47. Say the table of 8. 8 fives are 40 because 8 six are 48 and which is greater than 47. So we will take fifth step, 8 fives are 40. Now subtract 40 from 47. 7 minus 0 is equal to 7. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. Now copy down the next number. 5. Next digit is 5. So our new dividend is 75. Now say the table of 8. 8 nines are 72. Now we will subtract. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. And 7 minus 7 is equal to 0. So in this question, our quotient is 359 and our remainder is 3. Okay. Now next is verify and check the answer. That means, अगर हमने जो भी question solve किया है, उसको हम यदि check करना चाहते हैं, if we want to check that our answer is correct or not, तो हम उसको check कर सकते हैं. How? Let's see. Now, we have already solved this question. Okay, here 2875 is dividend, 8 is divisor, 359 is quotient and 3 is remainder. Now, we have to follow this formula. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor or divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, now the quotient is 359. The divisor is 8. Okay, divisor means by which we divide the number. Okay, now 8 is divisor and the remainder is 3. Quotient into divisor plus remainder, that means 359 into 8 plus 3. Now if we multiply these two numbers, 359 into 8, we will get the answer 2872 plus 3. Okay, if we plus with this number, we will get 2875 and this is our dividend. Agar ye solve karne, formula solve karne ke baad, jo answer aata hai, yadi ye dividend ke equal hai, that means our answer is correct. Hope you understand this topic. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.